The BCCI can organize 3 parts of the IPL across 13 months, but something as small as deciding the compensation that they have to pay India's domestic cricketers and match officials has taken them over 6 months. Virat Kohli and Ravi Shastri, before leaving for England, had warned of risking players' mental health with long stints in a bio bubble, but the BCCI has also chosen to ignore that and instead scheduled an IPL, which means most of India's big stars will now be on the road for the next 6 months. The Board of Control for Cricket in India has clearly decided that profits take priority, not the players and the people who make the game. Yes, even as the BCCI has managed to suspend and reschedule IPL 2021 to the UAE later this year, all in a matter of just 1 month, many of India's domestic cricketers who haven't played cricket for almost a year, match officials, ground staff, a lot of the people whose salaries solely depend on Indian domestic cricket are waiting for the board to announce the compensation package they had promised in December of 2020 after cancelling all Indian domestic tournaments apart from 2 men's events and 1 women's tournament. It can be understood that the BCCI is possibly struggling with who all to pay the compensation to. Full squads from the previous season that actually happened, or just the players who played matches in that season, or just probable squads. But would it not be better that instead of treading on the line of caution so as not to give money to any undeserving players, the BCCI actually hurries up the process since it's already been 6 months, even if it means paying, giving salaries to some of the players who probably don't deserve it or wouldn't have played this last season? Because as we know, we have seen in the media and just otherwise, lots of players, officials, ground staff have come out in public and spoken about how tough life has become for them, especially with no income coming in for over a year. Now, according to the financial reports posted on the BCCI's own website, in the last financial year, they paid 5 crore, 150 crore and 160 crore as advance tax in just the 3 quarters. That sort of would mean that the taxable income in just the 3 quarters was about 1500 crore. Take another 1500 crore that they earn, that's the lump sum they get from the IPL each season as for the broadcast rights from Star. Now, between the 36 state units and their different squads, the men's squad, women's squad, age group squads, and the different formats that they play, even if the BCCI would set aside 10% of either of the 1500 crores and set aside 150 crore to pay India's domestic cricketers, would that really be such a big hit for the richest cricket body in the world? And anyway, now we're seeing that the BCCI clearly is prioritizing profits and the IPL. And when else is there going to be a better time to utilize the profits that they make from the T20 league than to pay the players, pay the people who make cricket possible in the country? And while I'm on the topic of BCCI's priorities and the IPL, I'd mentioned a little while back about Virat Kohli and Ravi Shastri talking about the toll long lengths of time in a bio bubble could take on players' mental health, and both of them did mention it at length in the pre-departure press conference before leaving for England, before the IPL dates were announced. Virat Kohli said, and I quote, "With the kind of structure we are competing in, it is very difficult for the players to stay motivated and find the right kind of mental space for a long period, being confined in one area, doing the same stuff day in and day out, and dealing with high pressure situations." This was, of course, before the BCCI announced the IPL, and already this Indian team was supposed to be on a 4.5 month long tour of England. They're there already. It's June right now. They play the World Test Championship final and then a 5-match test series against England that ends on the 14th of September. Now, what would have been a 1 month that Virat Kohli, Rohit Sharma, KL Rahul, Jasprit Bumrah would have had to go back home, meet their families, de-stress, take some time out, work on their injuries. Well, that 1 month window has also been snatched away from them, with the BCCI prioritizing the IPL and scheduling the remainder of IPL 2021 in the window between India's tour of England and the start of the T20 World Cup. So despite the warnings, or the plea you may call it, sounded by Virat Kohli and Ravi Shastri on how such long spans of time spent in a bio bubble could affect players' mental health, the BCCI has simply decided that it's okay for a lot of the big star players to be away from home and on tour for 6 straight months till the end of the T20 World Cup on about the 15th of November. You can be destroyed mentally being asked to do the same thing day in and day out and then asked to perform. It's not easy to recover, especially if you've had a bad day, is what Ravi Shastri had said in that pre-departure press conference. So the question now that must be asked is if the system needs to be completely broken for it to be repaired, for the BCCI to realize the importance of the players and their health and their mental health, even their fitness, and not by forcing them to play non-stop cricket like they are right now. The ECB has a rotation policy for the players. It's been criticized heavily because a lot of players aren't playing a lot of big events, but then it also means that they have prioritized their players and ensured that they get time off, they get time at home, they get time to rest and be away from the bio bubble. When is that time going to come in Indian cricket? When is the BCCI going to prioritize their players and not their profits?